arrogance is not something to be proud of. Spectacular, a blind arrogance. We think we are so special. We think we are so important. That the whole world is our playground and that we have the right to take any life form without punishment. We think we are the crown of creation. Or on top of the food chain would actually mean the same. Only then the first one is used by people who believe in God. And the other believe in atheism most of the time. You know? Yeah, I know. We are not important at all. Being aware that if humans, our species, disappear from this planet, anything will benefit from it. And I say this not because I am mean. The great episode, actually. Because I want to show people the reality. If phytoplanktons, tiny marine plants, live in the hypopric zone of the sea, the upper layer of the sea, if these plants disappear, the whole ecosystem of the sea will collapse. That's important. Phytoplankton are. Also, if they disappear, something like 70% of all the oxygen on Earth will disappear. If also the rainforest then will disappear, we will die. And also, if we also will die if we lose 70% of all our oxygen on Earth. We live in one ecosystem. We live not apart from nature, like some of us delusional believe. Another very important factor of the ecosystem of the Earth are pollinators, like bees and butterflies. There are many reasons why they are important and we are not. For example, bees and other pollinators like butterflies and some birds are being responsible for the health of most plants on this planet and the growing of fruits, because most plants need pollination. The bee or the butterfly go to the stem or go to the flower and will drink from the flower, actually. Then the pollen sticks on the wings and the legs of the pollinators. And they go then to another flower. And that's how the plants, that's how the fruits are growing, and the other plants that grow on plants. Other plant food that grow on plants. Insects, for example, are the cleaners of this earth. Many insect species eat shit of other animals, and without them, we have extreme amount of shit all around. Beetles, some beetles eat shit. Some other animals, insects like snails, eat leaves. For example, and not only the leaves of your plants, but also dead leaves that lay on the ground. We need to understand that this world is a planet of great diversity in life forms, and that it is not one planet of one species, like most of us so insanely believe. I can make it not more beautiful than being and not appear on public relation. Agency. I say things people want me not to say. I say things people don't want to hear. I say things people must to hear. A vegan lifestyle costs the least amount of environmental damage, the least amount of water, and if anybody was vegan, we can easily stop world hunger and we can easily stop deforestation of rainforest and destruction of our seas. Worldwide, there are more than 500 appropriate dead zones, nitrate filled appropriate dead zones, zones in the ocean where not life is possible anymore. Because of pollution, the majority comes from all the shit that animals produce. From the amount of shit that they produce. Also, 51% of the greenhouse gas emissions are from animal exploitation industries, like the meat, dairy, and egg industry. Mainly the meat, dairy, and egg industry. Because 70 billion land animals. Shit, of course, a lot. According to my estimates, 500,000 tons of shit are produced any second worldwide by all the animals that humans consume, and therefore humans are directly responsible for that pollution. Rather to say people. Because the real meaning of persona is a mask, like the actors of ancient states. And you can say that our everyday conversations are nothing more than, well, we are at comedy. Extremely weird, sad comedy. Very poor riddance, if you ask me. We need to extend our compassion to all innocent living beings. I'll cause the least amount of harm possible they possibly can with the limits of their body. And we need to learn empathy. A human being, as Einstein have said, see themselves as something separate from the rest. When optional delusion of his consciousness. This illusion is a kind of prison for us. To restrict ourselves from only giving compassion to some close to us. Our family members, our friends, and maybe people of our society. We must learn to extend our compassion to all living beings and nature in its beauty. If men cannot learn this, we will not survive. We need to limit the populations of people then lower than 1 billion. And we have to do this intelligently. If it has been possible. Human beings are people. We lead small groups of human populations inside great wilderness areas. No human city or village should be bigger than 20,000 people have to learn to live in the harmony with the three laws of ecology. First, the law of finite resources. There is a limited amount of food and materials on this world. That means a limited in growth. Second, the law of diversity. Without some species, others will not survive. And we all are interconnected with each other. Strength of an ecosystem is dependent on diversity between species. If we not learn to live with this laws, we will not survive. And many species also don't want to survive because of our extremely arrogant clever. We are not the most intelligent species, but maybe we are the most clever. Because blind cleverness have created terror on this world, not intelligence. Intelligence, if you ask me, is the capacity of an organism to live in harmony with these three laws. The law of diversity, the law of independence, the law of finite resources. And maybe, show me how intelligent you are by causing the least amount of harm possible on this planet. By going vegan. What's the excuse for causing the least amount of harm possible on this planet? And say, don't be a douchebag to billions of innocent living beings. Humans don't need animal products to survive. Stop being a people and become a human. Go vegan.